Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss the preparation of the financial budget. We'll start off with a brief discussion of the purpose of budgeting and the role the financial budget plays in the organization. Next, we'll dive into the key elements of the financial budget and how it's prepared. Understanding how to build and utilize financial budgets significantly improves the likelihood of success within an organization. So let's get started. Have you ever wondered how companies make sure they have enough cash on hand to cover all of their costs each month? Organizations have numerous financial commitments on a monthly basis, such as payroll for their employees, variable costs for their materials, and fixed costs, such as rent or insurance. If they can't cover these costs, it's possible that they'll go out of business. This is why it's so important that companies plan in advance to ensure that they have the cash available to cover all of these commitments. And financial budgets are a tool that help them do this effectively. Companies can significantly improve the likelihood of success by spending time putting together financial budgets. Financial budgets not only allow the organization to plan for the future, but also allow them to set goals and track the company's performance. Regardless of the size of the business, financial budgets can provide a significant benefit to the organization. Budgets are financial plans that help companies determine the required actions necessary to meet their goals. These goals can be communicated throughout the organization to ensure all departments and employees are working together in alignment. Budgets also allow companies to plan for the future and monitor performance by comparing actual results to their original expectations and taking corrective action. Companies typically create what's called a master budget, which is the overall financial plan for the organization as a whole, and usually covers a one-year time frame. The master budget can be broken down further into two key areas: operating budgets and financial budgets. In this video, we're going to focus on the financial budgets, which detail the expected cash flows of the organization that would ultimately impact the balance sheet. This would include a cash budget that tracks all expected inflows and outflows of cash for the year, as well as a capital budget, which details the expected capital investment in new assets for the organization. This allows companies to produce a budgeted balance sheet and budgeted statement of cash flows. The capital budget helps companies plan for investment in new long-term resources that will be used in the company to generate revenue. These are things like the assets of the organization that the company is planning to purchase, such as new property, equipment, or vehicles. Once approved, the organization will need to ensure that they have plans in place to obtain the cash required to be able to make these purchases throughout the upcoming year. Next is the cash budget, which is one of the most important budgets for the organization. As without cash, the company likely cannot continue to operate. Managers need to be able to plan in advance for when they're expecting to have a cash shortfall so that they can obtain financing from either a bank or investors before it's too late. We'll look at an example of the cash budget shortly. It's a common misconception that once the budget is approved, it's set in stone and doesn't change. Now, while this is true of the original master budget, which is also sometimes called a static budget, companies have the ability to make adjustments to the budget once the year is underway. These adjustments are typically made to account for changes that have taken place in the business or economy following the completion of the budget. Say, for example, a company's competitor goes out of business during the year and suddenly they're the only player in town. Their inventory orders increase significantly, which changes the amount of cash they'll need to have on hand to fill these orders. In this case, they may need to reforecast their original budget in order to plan more effectively for the remainder of the year. Let's look at an example of how a company would prepare their cash budget. Remember, with a cash budget, we're trying to determine how much cash the XYZ bike company is expecting to have on hand at the end of each period so that they can make sure they have enough to meet their commitments. In this example, XYZ Bike Company is expecting the following in quarter one: an opening cash balance of $5,000. They're expecting quarter one cash sales to be $50,000, cash disbursements to be $40,000, and a minimum cash requirement of $20,000. These details would be used to create the following cash budget. The company has an opening cash balance before the quarter starts of $5,000 in their account. Next, we would add in any cash they're expecting to receive from sales to their customers throughout that quarter. In this case, $50,000, which would bring the total cash available for that quarter to $55,000. Lastly, we need to subtract out all the cash the company is planning to spend on things like materials, supplies, and wages, which in this case is $40,000 for the quarter. We now know that the company is expecting to have an ending cash balance at the end of quarter one of $15,000. Now remember, the company has a minimum cash requirement of maintaining $20,000 in their account at the end of each quarter. And based on this budget, currently they're only expecting to have $15,000. Once we account for this, we can see the company is going to have a cash shortfall of $5,000. So what can they actually do in this situation? Well, it's good news that they spent time putting this plan together in advance, because now at least they know they need to come up with an additional $5,000 that quarter to support the business. This means as soon as they have this information, they can go ahead and start seeking financing from either banks or investors to ensure that they have these funds required by the time that they need them. Now that the company knows their ending cash balance, this information will flow through to the preparation of their budgeted balance sheet and budgeted cash flow statement. Now that the cash balance is complete, the organization has the details required to update the expected cash balance on their budgeted balance sheet for the upcoming quarter. And that brings us to the end of this video. Remember, in order for organizations to be successful in the long run, they need an effective way to develop and communicate goals across the organization and ensure that they have enough cash flow to meet their commitments throughout the year. Financial budgets are an extremely useful tool that give companies the ability to do this. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.